that's just a sample of a few people on a bit of an impact. Gives you a flavour for some of the work that goes on. I think there's a proposal that actually Liverpool John Moores University are going to be doing an evaluation, a follow-up evaluation next year. And I think that's something that we can actually get involved in shaping what that evaluation looks like and what it focuses on, and then we use that evaluation in the recognition or the decisions going forward about how we commission the service or those lines of future. So that was the end of the presentation.
That's very much that, Dave. Certainly, I don't think anyone's questioning the value of the connectors and the really useful work they do. Certainly, what I wanted to look at was, is there any way that we can directly talk to them about doing some practical stuff just through this crisis at this point? Not saying don't care, I'll do what they're doing, but just over this period, just once we get through this cost of living crisis, whether or not we're able to support us through that. Councillor Camphor and Councillor Mutney.
Thank you, Chair. So, again, a conflict of interest on GP in Woodchurch. And the first patient I saw today, and I didn't know much about it, I had read the papers before, but came and told me about the spider project. And this is a patient who was very depressed, isolated, and living in his own flat, and is completely transformed. You know, completely transformed. And he was going on and on and on about how the spider project has helped him, how he gets out of his flat, how he meets other people, how he reads books, and how he talks, and how he does creative writing and all that. And that's had a huge impact in his life. This is in the middle of Woodchurch, and I think that was absolutely amazing. And I thought that the video was quite inspirational. Thank you.
Pilot projects run by CWP and other connectors. Councillor Mountney.
Chair, thank you. I agree with your sentiments, really. If we could narrow down their activities slightly for a period and produce some targeted and measurable results that we can bring back here.
So they are doing a number of activity, interventions as opposed to support around Castle. So they are the community pub, obviously within Involved North West, and they are providing, you know, food parcels, etc. for people. But we can look at the KPIs and look at how we measure some of that activity, but it is absolutely happening in terms of that support around Castle living from the service.
Thank you, Chair. For those of you that know, I've worked as a community director for 12 months, so I finished working there in March this year, obviously to concentrate on this role. Again, with the recommendations, I can only praise this colleagues there who go above and beyond. There's some phenomenal colleagues there who come from a range of different backgrounds, and have come into the connectors role from a range of different services. So I can personally vouch for the work that they've done. And obviously touch on the response to the pandemic in this report. I was brought in on that comp fund, which is mentioned in the report. Again, I've seen how valuable that was in terms of getting the COVID message out, home testing kits, testing units, that sort of thing. So yeah, I'm definitely happy with the recommendations there, but I do have I do believe what Councillor Nolan's mentioned and Councillor Martin this evening is important, because they have a lot of knowledge within the Connectors organisation. We're going through a huge squeeze on council resources, and the public are going through enormous pressures at the moment. And I personally think that Connectors in some ways are uniquely placed to help us deliver on some of the things. Getting the message out there, for example, we've seen on the committees and this committee people struggling in terms of what help is out there for them, how they can support people in their lives, you know, in terms of digital exclusion, that sort of thing. The door knocking side of it is a part of it. And each area is given targets each month, which is a concern for me, a target based thing. But within that door knocking, we could be that door lock and promotion of the connected service, there's nothing to stop leaf drops, and was giving their messages to go. It's public health only. People struggling to get access to cost of living payments for various things. We know as councillors, I'm sure we've all had these emails or phone calls from community members who are struggling to access because they can't get online to do this appointment here. I think we can be utilising the service. I say it's public health only, and I believe, and I know from working there that the connectors we might be behind this. Because you're not adding to the workload. It's about getting best value. Not just for money, but for the residents, you know, it's for the residents, isn't it? As I say, they aren't uniquely placed in a lot of ways, the connectors, to deliver this. So I've been for 12 months, I've only come out of it, very recently, and why not utilise when there's a very limited load group of people who want them? You don't go into that job for the pay. It can be an extremely heavy job at times. It can be a tedious job at times because there's a lot sitting down at times, but sometimes it can be a really quite a heavy, emotionally challenging job. So you don't go into that job for the quick book, you go into that job because you want to make a difference. Certainly, I went into it, and I believe the community connectors are really placed in some way, so I think we could be utilising them while we're going through the cost of living crisis amongst other things. I think we could be utilising them. Getting more value, if you like, for money and for the residents. Thank you.
Well, I was just speaking to a therapy service in Chester who was thinking of putting together an advocacy service as well, so they've been an advocacy and therapy service for the Wirral. I've actually put them in, I was reading this, so I've put them in touch with you because you're based in Rock, you've got a base in Rock Ferry that they could maybe use. They wanted to work in Birkenhead and Tranmere. But so anyway, you should be hearing from them. And they wanted to offer psychotherapy and counselling alongside all the work that you do. Conscious that everybody wants to be out, I can't imagine why. Right, so the recommendation is that we note the information, acknowledge the invaluable work the service undertaken. I'm going to add to that we take up what Nikki was suggesting, that there can be discussions with the community connectors about whether they can offer some practical support during the cost of living crisis. To say, my view would be things like safe and well checks, handing out warm packs, handing out food parcels, and so on, to individuals in the community as and when that's needed. But that would be something we'd have to discuss with them, whether they felt they could or they couldn't do that. So all we're asking is that the discussions take place. People are happy to add that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Chairs, our key members, this is the report that comes to each committee to enable you to comment on and contribute to the annual work programme. There are already a number of items on the work